Hello, my astrology family. This is Lada from astrolada.com, and I'm here with the most favorite astrologer to most of you, Nikola Stojanovic. Hi, Nikola.
Hey, hello, hello.
Long time no see.
Long time no see.
We're so excited that you're here with another installment of your unbelievable and unique knowledge, where it's nowhere in the world in other astrology books.
Yeah, I'm quite aware of that, yeah.
and that's why people look forward to all the videos.
I came from Canada, you know, to meet me, you know, and to buy my books also. And when she enters my apartment and her eye was wide open and she starts saying, "You're a genius, you're a genius, you're a genius." And I was calm, you know, but you are, you know, she thought, I'm not, I don't think about myself. I'm a genius, you know, but I told her I know that, you know, so you are not surprising me.
Oh my God, the humbleness.
Aquarius, at the degree of Aquarius. Okay, okay.
And Nikola is making a course. It's only $29, guys. We try and make it as most affordable to everyone. Till the 8th of June is $29. And it's on the exaltations and rulerships of planets and signs. And we're going to talk about that today. So, Nikola, you have the word.
Yeah, thank you. It is very important to know where planets are in the sign, in what sign they are in the sign of exaltation, and also the opposite, you know, what is the fall of planets and the detriment too, you know. Why it is important, you know, because we all live the life that planets gives us from our chart, you know. So it is very important to know what is the most powerful planet in our chart, or what planet is not in power, you know, it has bad energy or something like that. And for, you know, there are many different opinions. For some planets, we know exactly what is the sign of exaltation and also fall, you know, opposite. But for some of the planets, we don't know that, you know, and there are different opinions. So we will talk about that. I know, you know, the truth. I mean, for example, there is different opinion about the sign of exaltation of Mercury, of Neptune, and Pluto, you know.
And yes, especially the new planets that I discovered recently.
Yeah, and also, I will explain, for example, we all know that the sun is in the sign of exaltation, in the sign of Aries. And I will explain why. So, you know, every science has its own logic. So astrology too, you know, astrology is a science. And I will use astrological logic, you know, to explain, you know, why the sun is in the sign of exaltation, in the sign of Aries, and the moon in Taurus, you know. And I will explain about these three planets that people have different opinions, you know, especially Mercury, Neptune, and Pluto. So, for example, how it works in our lives. For example, the chart of Adolf Hitler, you know, the leader of Nazi Germany, you know. So he started the war, and at the end he lost it, you know, and it was very difficult lose, you know, for him and his nation, his country, you know. Why, you know? Why he lost the war? He has the Mars, ruler of Aries, war, in the sign of Taurus, you know. It is weak Mars, you know. Mars is in trine with Jupiter, you know, it's very good aspect for winning war, you know. But where is his Jupiter? In the sign of Capricorn, you know. And Jupiter is in the sign of exaltation, in the sign of Cancer. So Capricorn is the fall of Jupiter, you know. So he has two weak planets, you know, in good aspect, but weak. And especially Mars is in square with Saturn, you know, in the sign of Leo, you know. Saturn.
Exactly.
Yeah, exactly. So Saturn is second ruler of Aquarius, you know, but in the sign of Leo, it is weak Saturn. So he lost war because of weak planets.
Wow, but since he had luck, he was winning because
at the beginning,
of trine Mars.
Because his seventh house, the house of war, the beginning of the seventh house is in Aries, you know, but he has Mars in Taurus, mm-hmm. in the seventh house, you know, it's weak Mars, you know. And also Mars in Taurus, Taurus are Jew people, you know, so he was against Jew people, Mars, you know, to be angry at them and to be against them. And square to Saturn, why did he lose war? In the beginning, you know, he came near Moscow. But what happened, you know, Mars square Saturn, Saturn rules with everything cold, so it means with winter, you know.
Oh,
so
yes.
Winter came, you know, he start losing war. And we all know in Russia, you know, you have very long and very strong winters. So astrologically, that was the reason why he lost war. So, okay, and also, for example, Mars is in the sign of exaltation, in the sign of Capricorn. We all know that, and it is true. And I will explain why. You know. Now I can give a hint. For example, Mars rules with Magneto. You know.
Magnet.
Yeah, yeah. So when people are traveling around the world, most of them buy souvenirs. You know, this is from Marbella, from Spain, and what we have behind it is magnet. You know, okay. And where we put that on the fridge? Why on the fridge? Mars is Magneto in the sign of exaltation. Mars is in Capricorn. Capricorn represents everything cold. You know, so. The fridge is Capricorn and Saturn. So we put Mars, Magneto, on the door of our fridge, you know.
Whoa, I love your logic.
Yeah, how it works. Everybody do it, everybody. You know. So you will not put it on the table or somewhere else. You will put it on the fridge. You know.
Wow, amazing.
So I will give a lot of examples, you know, how planets. For example, Mercury is in the sign of Pisces, in the sign of detriment or fall. You know. I will tell that on webinar, you know, what is right. So Mercury in the sign of Pisces is weak. Mercury is communication, okay? Language, you know, communication. And what we have, the only species that doesn't have communication are fish, you know, fish in the sea. Why? Because Mercury is very weak. In the sign of Pisces, Mercury to communicate, to talk, you know, any kind of way of talking, you know, so they don't communicate, fish. But listen this, somebody might say, but the dolphins are talking, they have communication, whales also.
But they're not fish.
But they are not fish, they are mammals.
Well, it's true. We have a saying in Bulgaria, quiet as fish. Why are you as quiet as a fish?
Why you're quiet as a fish? Mercury in the sign of... So I will give lots of examples. I will also represent the interesting charts of, you know, famous people or some other people, how it works in reality, you know. You know, very strong planet, very weak planet, and how it works. So we'll talk about that. And yes.
I want to ask you something. There is controversy about Mercury. Is it exalted in Gemini or in Aquarius? Aquarius.
In Aquarius normally, but I will explain. Listen, Mercury rules with birds, okay? And they all talk Mercury. And you have a parrot, you know, they can talk like humans, okay? Mercury, talking Mercury birds, okay? And it is in the sign of exaltation in Aquarius. Why? Where are birds flying? Very up in the sky, you know. And Aquarius is very up in the sky. One of the proof, you know, not the only one. I won't say everything now, you know, but it is the sign of exaltation. Mercury is in Aquarius. Mm-hmm. And I will explain. There are lots of examples for that.
So you think that when we have planets in fall, say, like you said, gave example with Hitler, three planets in weeks, we shouldn't use best not to use those planets or not to try to win with them something or do something.
We should not, you know, if you have a trine, you know, it's good aspect, you know, so we can use the trine, but we must avoid the Mars square Saturn, in his case, Mars square Saturn. So, you know, he should start war. He attacked the Russians in June, you know, he should do that in April. You know? April is Mars, ruler of April is Mars, you know, the sign of Aries. So he lost, you know, and he lost 2 months, you know. So he might win the war, you know, if he started the war before. But, you know, he has in his chart that he had to lose war. So it did happen, you know.
What if he came to you and you were alive then and said, tell me what to do? Would you help him? Or would you tell him, don't start?
I would tell him, be a painter, you know. His ascendant is in Libra, art, you know. And he wanted to be a painter, you know.
He couldn't, yeah.
His first choice, you know, the ascendant in Libra, to be a painter. But Libra also rules with politics, you know. And he has the ruler of the first house in the seventh house, the house of politics. So that's why he couldn't be a painter, you know. So he turned that energy into politics. Mm-hmm. And later war, because Mars is there too.
Can I ask a few questions? What if you have a really strong planet in its own sign, say Saturn in Capricorn or Venus in Pisces, exalted, but if it has hard aspects, what would you do with such a planet?
The better energy, the stronger energy. You know, Venus, we should force the energy of Venus in Pisces, you know. Or, but, you know, Saturn in Capricorn, if Saturn has some bad aspect from other planets. Saturn is the ruler of Capricorn, so we should force the energy of Saturn off in Capricorn. That's the point, you know. We must choose, you know. But, you know, squares and oppositions will give us issues, problems, you know, all the time. But we should use to it, you know, and fight. What to do?
So is it, and if you have a weak planet, say Venus in Virgo, with good aspects, how does it play out then? What do you do?
This is from my school of astrology, what I say to my students. We can force the energy. Planet is not, for example, my daughter, she has Mercury in Pisces, ruler of her ascendant. And when the time comes for her to go to school, I was thinking what to do, you know, because she might be a bad pupil, you know, and I didn't want that. You know. And what did I do? You know, Mercury in Pisces. Mercury is to learn. Pisces is isolation. So when she came back from school, you know, she ate, you know, and after that she went in her room, closed the door, and she was learning, you know. And when somebody calls her by phone, you know, something like that, her friends, I told them, you know, listen, Jovana is now learning. When she finishes her learning, she will call you, don't worry. And I, you know, my daughter was born in the sign of Aquarius, so friends are very important in her life.
Mm-hmm.
So I said, okay, listen, when you come back from school, eat, okay, you know, have some rest and go to learn. After, when you finish your learning, you can do whatever you want. You can go out with your friends, no problem. But first learn. And she did it, you know. And she was isolated, Pisces. So what I want to say, when you use energy of the planet, like Mercury in Pisces, through the sign of Pisces, through, you know, what represents the sign of Pisces, some kind of isolation. So in her room, there is no laptop, there is no telephone, nothing. You know. She's learning. Nobody, even me and her mother, we didn't enter the room to see what is she doing. No, learn. And she was the best pupil in the school, you know.
Oh, wow.
The best pupil. But why also? She has Mercury conjunction Saturn. Saturn gives great memory. So this is aspect very good. So, you know, when she came back home, she read something once. And her Mercury is at the fifth degree of Pisces. Fifth degree is Leo degree. Leo is to listen to teacher. Leo rules with teachers. So I asked her. So I saw that she's not learning too much. She's the best student, pupil, you know. So I ask her, what is your magic? What are you doing? Why are you the best? You know. So she told me, you know, Mercury at the fifth degree. At school, I'm listening my teacher. So when she comes back home, she read, you know, what she should learn only once. And Mercury, Saturn, great memory. Mm-hmm. So that's why she was the best, one of the best pupils at school. You know.
So actually, even if you have like a planet in a sign with difficult aspects, if you use the energy of the sign correctly and of those planets, you can, even a difficult position, you can turn it to your benefit.
Yes, you can. Yeah. So look what I did with her, you know. She was isolated, you know, Pisces. So I used the energy of her Mercury Pisces. So, you know, when she was learning, she was completely alone by herself.
Well, can I ask you, sorry, Venus in Virgo, a lot of people have problems when they have Venus in Virgo.
Virgo is our, when we work, at work. So it means, you know, when a woman with Venus in Virgo wants to seduce a man, you know, she should call him to visit her at work, because at her work she will look, you know, pretty and, you know. Do you understand? This is the way she can, you know, a woman with Venus in Virgo, you know. And also, especially, you know, women dressed, for example, nurses, you know, they all have their own dress, you know, at work. Or when she's walking a dog, because Virgo is ruler of pets. Mm-hmm. So go out, walk your dog, you know.
Go out in your nursing outfit, walk your dog.
Through the sign, you know, with the symbolic of the sign of Virgo.
That's a great remedy.
So, you know, I say to my students, there is no weak planet if we know to use them.
Oh, I love that.
That's the point.
I want everyone to remember this, guys. There is no weak planet if you know how to work with it.
That's the point, you know.
Okay, Mars in Cancer.
Please tell me, excuse me.
Mars in Cancer. Remedies.
It's good for building homes, fantastic, you know. Or to have fire at home, you know, fireplace. Uh-huh. Or to paint the walls, one wall should be red, Mars roots is red color. You know. So it's good energy, you know. And listen, one lady, she has a similar Mars in Cancer in the forehead. So she came to me and told me, I'm fed up, you know, every time I come back home from work, I'm tired. And when I come back home, Mars fight at home. Between her, you know, parents, you know, her child, blah, blah. Everybody's fighting Mars, fourth house at home. Yeah. So she asked me, what can I do? You know, I will go mad. So I told her, paint the front door into the red color. Mars is red.
Oh.
And several months later, she came to me again, and you know, she told me, oh, thank you, it helped, you know. We are fighting there, but not too much as before. Because the energy of Mars went of the Mars is red color, on the red color door, front door.
Wow, that's awesome. I am painting my parents' door red because my dad has Mars in Cancer. They're always fighting. You can hear them from the floor.
Somebody is building the house or home, you know. I say, Mars is also fire, you know. Cancer is our home. So one day, you know, our home might caught fire, you know, disaster. So what to do, you know? So I'm telling them, when you build your home, you know, don't finish work, you know. Put something undone. Something not important. Do you understand? Maybe one brick is missing. Don't put that brick there.
Why?
Because he will say, I will finish it. So it means he will be all his life in process of building it.
Ah, so it's always as if he's using Mars to build.
To build the home. You know? So don't finish it. You know?
Oh, that's genius.
Okay. It works, you know. It was the very important. It all works.
What about Saturn in Leo?
Saturn in Leo. Buy some old gold, you know. Saturn is something gold. The Leo is gold, you know. Buy old coins or old gold coins, something like that. Mm-hmm. Or old glasses, old style of glasses. Leo roof with our sight and glasses normally. So, or have an old mirror at home, Leo roof with mirror.
Uh-huh.
So an old style mirror.
Uh-huh. Oh, anything old, second hand. Second hand.
So okay. In that, but also people must be aware, you know, Saturn in Leo is not good for our back or our spine, you know, so they have to eat more food rich with calcium. Because calcium, Saturn rules with calcium, and it also rules with our bones, you know, and teeth, you know. So Saturn in Leo is weak, so they should eat more, you know. You must, you know, many good, great sportsmen, they have Mars in Cancer, weak Mars, you know. Mm-hmm. But what they do, they practice a lot, even more than others. And in that way, you know, they force the energy of Mars, practicing, you know, training. So in that way, they become one of the best or best sportsmen.
Sorry, they have Mars in Cancer or Saturn?
They have Mars in Cancer. You know. For example, Federer, tennis player, Federer, he has Mars. I think he has Mars in Cancer. And Novak Djokovic also, Serbian number one now, you know. He has Mars in Cancer. But he's practicing all the time, you know. He's forcing the energy of Mars, forcing, you know. Mm-hmm. Maybe more than others. And now he is number one for many years in tennis.
So yeah, even the planet that you consider weak can turn into your...
Yes, if you build energy to that planet, it's great.
Okay, Jupiter and Capricorn.
Jupiter and Capricorn, to make money in older days, you know, when we are a bit older, Capricorn older, you know, or to work with some, you know, old people or something old, you know, secondhand. So, and also Capricorn rules with diamonds. It's great, you know. Mm. And Capricorn rules with everything gold, you know, all furniture, you know, antique.
And that means
to save money. So people with Jupiter in Capricorn will have money if they save money. They should save money more than others.
Okay, two more. Venus in Aries, because it's a weak position for
women. Oh, no, it's not for women. Listen, for men. When man has Venus in Aries, what does it mean? He likes to be seduced from a woman.
So woman,
nice lady, Venus, is attacking her, him.
Uh-huh.
He is the one to be, you know, to run for him, not him. So he will behave like a woman sitting and waiting her.
Oh, okay.
So, you know, it's easy, you know. So he can't find a woman, but woman will find him.
Good.
And he only has to say yes. And also, when a woman has Venus in Aries, it means her head must be nice, you know. Hair, Aries rules with our head, you know.
Okay.
go every day to make a nice hair. You know.
Okay, I remember that. Thank you. That's a great
thing. And also, Venus in Aries. Aries is to be slim. No. But not too thin. No. It's not good. But, you know, it means, and also hairstyle, you know, many women with Venus in Aries, they have a hairstyle like men, very short hair.
Mm-hmm.
They look nice then.
I'm not putting my hair.
But many of them. But you have a nice hair, don't worry.
Jennifer Aniston has Venus in Aries, and her hair was always so well done, you know.
Her hair must be well done.
Okay, Venus in Scorpio, that's another hard position to complain a lot about.
Sexy, you know, sexy lady, sexy moves, you know, sexy dress. And they like, women with Venus in Scorpio, they like to be touched all the time, everywhere. Believe me.
Okay.
It means, you know, when you do that with her, you know, it means he loves me, he wants me, blah, blah. So, you know, when a woman has a Venus in Scorpio, it's great, I like it.
So what is the remedy for them? Because they go in those deep emotional states in love, like they get obsessive. So
it's Scorpio, you know, it's love or and hate, you know, it's between all the time love and hate. So, but it's their way to express love and it. You know. Mm-hmm. So they fight, you know, when they fight with men, great, you know. It's good for them, you know. it's not when you see them fighting, you know, you can think they're crazy, they should split, you know, separate, but it's their way of love. Venus is good.
There must be. They also have a dramatic relationship.
When there is no passion, no love, there is no love.
There is no fighting either.
Mm-hmm. And listen, fighting is the same planet Ruth is fighting, and same planet Ruth is sex, you know. Mars and Pluto, you know, okay, Pluto is hate. And very strong emotions, you know, and very, very strong. But Mars is sex, Mars is fight, you know. So it goes together, you know.
They should fight and have sex. Fight.
Yeah.
And
both, you know.
Or just have more sex so they don't fight.
Yeah, but they have to fight also. They can't avoid it.
Thank you so much, Nikola. It's always a joy.
So here you on 8th of June, okay? And see you in Bulgaria at 19th of June.
20th of June.
So June is a great month for us.
I know, can't wait. Nikola said there'll be lots of drinking on those days because Mars is conjunct Mercury, so let's see.
Oh, yeah, there will be. I will try to avoid.
In Cancer, they're in Cancer.
Drinking, yeah.
Oh my God.
We'll all be drunk.
The spiritual teachers, just trolling.
Yeah,
Come see us, how elevated and how kind of holy we are. But thank you so much, Nikola.
Okay, so see you soon. 8th of June.
And looking forward to see you on the 8th of June. That will be, I think, Saturday or Sunday. Yeah. So it's $29 only, guys. Come and join us. Looking forward to seeing you all there. Bye-bye.
Bye-bye. Bye-bye.